when the platform is set. We talk tough. Discussing issues of national concern. One full hour of patriotic discussion with difficulty. This and every Friday, exclusively on Aaron TV. Flashpoint, Liberia is getting better.
Well, thank you very much and good morning to everybody. This is Flashpoint, the voice of the coalition, and I'm David Koti. My guest today is Mr. Sam P. Jala. He is the head of the laboratory department of LPRC. And if you don't know, let me just inform you, that entity is the entity that has your vehicle, your generators, your airplanes moving very well today without any complaints. They are there to make sure that no bad fuel or gasoline is taken to the public to destroy your vehicles. He's going to tell you more about it. Mr. Jala is also a lecturer at the University of Liberia, I think.
UMU
and so on.
Two different high schools.
Two different high schools and universities. So he's not a small potato in this country. Neither is he a small potato at LPRC. Because somebody who is responsible to make sure that our gas, our vehicles run well without any problem, that is somebody who I think we can give some high respect to. Welcome again to Flashpoint.
Mr. Kodu, all we can say is thank you for the kind of contribution you're making to our country. To me, our voices be here. Who I will invite here will make me for the people of Liberia.
Thank you. You have been here on two or three occasions, and every time you came here, you made some great impact.
Correct.
And I'm very sure today is going to be no exception. Okay, let's begin by talking about your mandate at the entity. What do you really do there? You are the head of the laboratory department at LPRC. Tell us about your mandate. We'll come to the activities of the lab, not that. But what is your mandate? What are you supposed to be doing?
In one word, quality assurance and control.
Okay. One word, quality assurance and control. In other words, you must ensure that we have quality fuel, quality petroleum on the market.
Sure, correct.
And how effective are you in this area?
100%. If there's anything called more than 100, I would have called you. But I'm a student of number, 100%.
100%. Well, people normally say 114%.
Those are something in literature we call saturation. People say this thing on the business television, but for us who play with number, we are scientists. Exactitude is our fight.
Huh.
So it's 100%.
In science, you must be exact.
Oh, that's it.
Not below that, on top, not guessing.
Correct.
That's all right. Well, if you haven't listened to him before, just listen carefully. You're going to hear more today. Now, quality and?
Quality control and quality assurance.
Control and quality. All right. Now, tell us a little bit now about your department. Your mandate is to ensure control and quality. But tell me a little bit more about the lab itself. Now, how equipped is your lab to do this job?
Again, Mr. Cody, I want to say thank you. The country will remember you for these things because we do encourage you kind of conversation. You're going to help in different facets of the country and the developmental drive of this country. First of all, let me use the time to extend gratitude to the management of the PIC.
Okay.
Starting with the head, which is Malikuma. I want to say thank you for taking over that institution and the role you've played so far. And my immediate boss, Mr. Adrian Hoff, I want to say hi and thank you too.
Okay.
And also Mr. Bobby Brown, who sometimes people refer to as a walking cycle player of LPIC. Now to your question, Mr. Koti, the laboratory, being the quality arm of LPIC, I can tell you we are politics, we are breaking with everything, but it's shown. It's not like I normally say, science is what you put in is what you get out. The laboratory is at 100% in terms of equipment, in terms of staff, in terms of analysis, and what we do there. So the laboratory being the quality arm of LPRC. You know, the LPRC is a conglomeration of different departments.
Yeah.
You must have the marketing. For us, we are concerned strictly with quality. And as per your question, I want to say we are uncles. And yeah. Our output is showing that. I did not mention the popular complaint. You wouldn't believe that gasoline, in terms of older, sometimes goes to the point that it becomes muscle. And with that happening, how disease will win around this country? Not enough talk about the environmental impact assessment of that. So yeah, we are 100%, and in terms of quality, we are. In terms of equipment, all of our equipment are ISO standard certified and ASTM standard certified. That is the international standard organization. ISO certified.
Say that again.
All of our equipments are ISO standard certified. ISO is the international standard organization. For our sector of the international standard organization, it's coded as 17025. That is the standard that has to do with the prerequisite of competence of testing laboratory. We've met that. We've altered that. And that is the reason why the equipment we procure are all at the standard. Now, the second code is the ESTM. That is the American standard for testing material. DO2, that talks about standard and policy and regulation in terms of manual development, and the intellectual part of it, and the quality and scientific output. So yeah, we are, the laboratory is just up to standard that we meet anywhere around the world. And like I say, our records are there.
How much does the entity, LPRC, depend on your department for success?
Let me get make that as a scenario so that you see the picture, so that you can look at it and bragging about it. When the vessel, the one we call ship, arrives into this country with hydrocarbon or with petroleum product, and the management is informed. For that product to be discharged or given to Liberia, laboratory must be the one speaking.
Okay.
So Jeff and I say now you should know the role we play, you know how important we are. I can see this for a fire and free, which is a scientific best practice. We are a laboratory, entity of that nature only exists.
Okay.
In fact, you wouldn't be compared to all our national, international, and national standard. That's why we refer to as quality. Like you and I have some an offer composition. Everything on earth can be tested.
Mm-hmm.
Must meet quality. The clothes you wear, they got laboratory to test the fabric, they test the quality of it. The shoe you wear, the car you ride, all material you think of. That's why they got the ESTM. I'm saying American standard for testing material.
No.
So yeah, so just by the story that I made, will tell you the importance and significance of the LPI, of the laboratory at LPRC.
So in other words, you are saying that without that laboratory department, there will be no LPRC.
There can be no beer. Right? Let not make it so all of the common men we see as being like this thing, but when there is a petroleum entity of that kind, laboratory is coined within the fundamental establishment. Without it, there will be nothing called LPRC.
Mm-hmm.
Because the product must come, it must be quality. How do you know that?
Right, because you're dealing strictly with petroleum.
Perfect.
You're not dealing with stationaries.
Thank you.
It's strictly petroleum.
Sure.
So in other words, for our vehicles to be safe, for the planes to be safe, for the generators to be safe, you must have a department that will be able to ensure that those things happen.
Sure.
So if the laboratory is not there, but tell me about your staff a little bit. Do you have competent staff?
I do not just have competent, but qualified.
Yeah, I'm not concerned about the qualification. Sometimes people are qualified. You know,
and
I have
not
told
competent.
People. I have told people many times. We've got people who have papers here, degrees. You know, this country, Liberia, believes in paper. Once you don't have paper, you're not fit.
Sure.
According to many people in this country,
sure.
You must have paper. So that's why many people by degrees, they pay for these things.
And like that, output becomes superficial.
All right, that's right. So I'm not concerned about qualification. People, anybody can buy paper and say he's qualified. But my question is, how competent is your staff?
If I'm grading the competence level and grade of my staff as relates to our standard and petroleum output quality, the least they will take is 9%. And the reason I'm giving that person 89% is because of their years served in the terrain and the environment. Because like you said, right, qualification comes from the academic and theoretical learning and acquisitions of the paper.
Mm-hmm.
Competence comes from the hands-on.
That's right.
The short-lived person in my laboratory currently have gone 7 years. Isn't that a normal of competence building? The equation will show that it's equal. The left and the right hand side will be equal.
Yeah.
So it's 89%.
I saw two beautiful ladies at your... in your department, and you wanted for one of them to even come and appear one time, because according to you, you don't want to be the only one always coming.
Simple, I want to decentralize.
And you wanted for one of the two to come. Now, are they still there?
They are still there.
And you wish for them
and
to
I'm
come
I'm proud of them, very ambitious.
Oh, okay.
And you may not believe that as we speak, the both of them are pursuing their masters.
Oh.
All of female would have been complacent.
Okay.
I've got a job that carried me for 25 years. I'm going to retire it and start being paid on that a diet. But the females, with all the degree they've earned, with all the quality knowledge they've earned, training, they are still pursuing master in scientific areas.
Hmm.
And both of them, I got Yen Tiyi, which is a chemist,
yeah.
And I got Angie Valerie Henry, who is also a chemist. I'm very proud of them. In fact, again, like I told you, some few months ago, I was in India. One of them took over the line and oversaw everything I went there.
Yeah.
And nothing happened.
We're going to come to that trip later, but right. Tell me a little bit about your equipment. You just told me, when I went to appeal to you to be here, you showed me some very new equipment.
Sure.
New equipment that just came. Tell me about the new equipment.
Normally what happens is, because science is dynamic, equipment procurement in laboratory must be on a periodic basis, on the basis of the trend and change in the scientific world. So when you are preparing your budget as a laboratory here, what you want to do is to follow the international world in terms of the scientific output and what comes up. Because like I told you the last time, the quality of crew will determine the origin of the crew. Now, because of the advancement of science now, we've got hydrocracking of hydrocarbon, then we got the demo-cracking, then we got the full standard and distillations of those things. And as per the demo, the plastic property of those things, it determines the kind of quality analysis you're going to make. So the equipment will change in terms of the precision and accuracy that they put on. So the repeatability and the probability tests that come, the marginal range, you want to have it lower to 0.5. You don't want up to 1. So because of that, you go for the kind of equipment. And like I said, and like you said, you saw them, we procure new equipment that fit in the category to give us a very minimal precision error so that we can fit the market and fit the international standard, that we can all be into the global world. Like we all say, the world is a global society, so we can't have that world doing something other than that. And like I told you, you heard the story, we had one importer that challenged our test, and we went abroad, we came better off. Why you think so? It's because of the way we handle things at the laboratory. Okay, the vessel came with AGU, they won't normally call diesel fuel. We thought it had residue problem. Residue actually is the kind of formation at the bottom of every liquid, which is not good for hydrocarbon, because if it's able to put it into a machinery for usage, and it's going to have that fluid and the ignition point or the spark point, it go by drops. In the period of time drop that ignition point, the octane number of who is fine. So that was one of the problems we saw. We also saw sulfur content. For sulfur content in quality analysis, those are kind of tell we call for environmental purpose. Because when sulfur is in hydrocarbon and it goes to burn into anything, sulfur goes into the air form with oxygen for sulfur oxide, which is by carcinogenic from cancer to the body. So when we told them they have a problem, you know that normal thing in Liberia now. First of all, we are young, people to take advantage of that.
Yeah.
But if they know that wisdom is not by age.
No.
It's on the basis of your own interest and your opportunity and your goal. And we have the nerve to stand to those things. So when we made our proclamation on the basis of either there must be some treatment of minimal acquisition for quality standard, or better still, there must be a thing down the product. It was saying that we were like seeking for some kind of honor here or envelopes. We are not the perfect or the God injured ones, but we love our country. Besides that, we love our job. One of the training I got during my professional studies.
That was going to be my next question. Just continue this one.
Perfect.
Because I want to find
so
out
yeah, so to bring things quicker and just make it succinct, we told him it wasn't good. So in the calling of that importer, they said no. They show their products, so they want to break on them. We're at the point where the vessel has stayed a longer time. There is something called demurrage. They wanted LPRC to pay that money. I told LPRC don't pay. It was bad. During that time, it was even the PSM was here. I could not blame her because she's not in the field of quality. So she called and said, Jala, are you sure that to her? Yeah. She said, because if you challenge the people in the wing, it would be a problem in the company. What's your advice? And one good thing I chose her, that's why I love her turning you there at the time. And the LPR is always blessed with good leadership. They listen to all the leaders that come over, they listen to their favorite department professionals and take it and live by your word. I told her, she called the company and told the company, we take the challenge. So she asked me what I wanted in the challenge. I said I wanted my technician to follow me, myself, and we won't be there for the challenge of the test. And now to go do the analysis behind my back. So the the sale company took the responsibility to buy our plane ticket via our lodging plan. We went there. And you may not believe.
You went where?
We went to SGS, an international French company in Abidjan. One of the biggest laboratories that West Africa can go to for any kind of quality in terms of hydrocarbon.
Okay.
When we got there, we slept in the hotel the next day. We went for the test. And we could see some of the conversation that I can't see about the guys. We could see that they wanted to play. But again, professionalism is 100%. That's what happened. Your apple become perfect. So I told them what I wanted and laid down a good rule for scientific analysis. And it must be your BWIS, by best practice, by ASTM standard, and by ISO standard. And as a certified quality analyst and expert, I expected them to leave by, and they agreed. Some of the excuses they started giving, they started pointing at equipment, in their opinion, telling me that the equipment was faulty, so they could not do a particular test. But you may not believe that there are test machines do. I use solution analysis to do the test. I don't need machine. I just need chemical, and I will do the test. And I will get qualitative output. While the machine gives me quantitative output, and the results will still show the same picture. So when they did the test, you may not believe that some of the results, we said it was 3, which is not bad. They were showing 4, 5.
So it was even worse than what you predicted.
That's what I'm telling you. And I could tell you why it was. Well, that didn't mean that we were not doing better yet. But you see, when it comes to hydrocarbon, the climatic condition and environment would take different quality output. Mm-hmm. So we knew what was happening and what would have happened even before we went there.
Now, my next question. As a very young man, I don't want to ask your age. I'm already 66,
but I'm not going to ask.
Oh, you want to call some ladies?
I'm 37.
The ladies are listening.
I'm not going to pretend on my age.
The ladies are listening.
1982, June 21.
The ladies are
I'm
listening.
I'm proud of that age.
Okay.
People who have that age, I think they are not proud of their parents. I can see that.
All right. Okay. Well, I submit the ladies don't listen at this hour, so I let her call my age. I'm 66. All right. As a young man, you still need money. You're still looking for money. You're not like some of us now who are about to go back to heaven. Now, you still got a long time here. You need some good money to build your very nice house.
Correct.
To get some very good SUVs to drive around and to go to some parties. You need some good money in your pocket. Have you never been tempted before to receive some very good envelopes from some of these vessels? You know, those are big boys with big money. But before you answer that, the program is Flashpoint, the voice of the coalition, and I'm David Cote. Today we have a special guest in studio from LPRC. He's Mr. Sam P. Jala, a very young man, and he's the head of the laboratory department at LPRC. That department, that is the major, major point of LPRC. Without it, according to him, there'll be no LPRC. Because these are the people, LPRC deals with petroleum, fuel, gas, and so on. In fact, 3 different fuel items.
Four.
Okay, he will name them to you. They got the jet fuel for airplanes. And you have the gas, they call
PMS.
PMS, and the AGO, the fuel.
AGO.
AGO.
That's
all right.
Diesel.
Thank you. Now, these. Okay, that's right. He wanted to name them to you. Now, these are the people who will tell you this is good for consumption. I see the reason why my vehicle is not 8 years old, 8 years plus, and still going well, because of you people.
Sure.
So he is here today to tell us all of these things about what they're doing there. But the entity, that particular department, is very important when it comes to LPRC. Without it, there will be no need for LPRC, because nobody is going to come and just dump anything. And now coming back to the question, I learned sometimes that these people with big money, they bring their vessels here, millions of dollars. Fuel on board or gasoline on board, and they want to offload, and you have told them already, look, we have done a test, this thing is not good, we can't allow you to dump it in Liberia. You will spoil people's vehicles, you will spoil people's generators, and you will destroy people's planes. But then they say to you, look, young man, come, let's talk, here's 500,000. Have you never been tempted to receive something like that before?
I would love to hear if I say I have me. In fact, one of the things I've said to you previously on my program, my whole life I've been quality control. When I was at Firestone, I worked in the latex laboratory. When I was at Simeco, I worked in the centimeter laboratory. When I was at SG, I worked in the iron ore laboratory. All my work have been quality. And you know, like you said, quality, when it comes to quality, that's where conversation come with the kind of unscrupulous way and sometimes. But again, I learned something that I've always tried to stick by. Money is not everything.
Money is not everything.
No. your reputation is the one that really carries him, more especially as a professional. If you must stay, you said something. Many a times, people who lose one job intend to not get another for a longer time because of their hard and career. Mm-hmm. If I tell you the successive way I got a job, you wouldn't believe it. In fact, there were jobs I was on before I took it. My last job was SGS. I was at SGS when I went to apply at LPRC and got this job. I still got a newspaper that gave me the job at LPRC. Nobody recommended me to LPRC. That newspaper came out April 1, 2014 by Inquirer when they were looking for only a single came in and almost 300 persons applied. And I got that job. I can make more from that because I got prima facie evidence. I'm going to keep that newspaper for my first child to see it, to tell him that merit base is in Liberia. And many a time when you go for a thing with all your heart, you get it through merit. And when you get it through merit, then it's staying a better and long life for you. So you will sometimes have the guts and the nerve to stand temptation, more especially when it comes to corruption. Because my, you know, the thing about the job market that most professionals don't understand is, in a particular terrain, you could be serving somebody as a customer. In a particular terrain, that person could be your employer. How do they see you? Now, all the people that are importing petroleum product, the day I decide to leave enterprise and I'm the one to work in their entity, why are they going to be saying that, oh, we know the man. We know how to tell them, and you bring this in here. So what happens to our work? So yeah, I have been tempted, but just for the caveat we sounded with that issue that I told you that carried out to Abidjan, a lot of people don't have the nerve to come with such conversation. And I can tell you that it's because of those kind of stance we've taken. It's why you're seeing the market being the way the market is. And like you said, when you go following your program, I'll tell you some feature plan that we have on the ladder that will be hitting 2020. Okay. Only the leadership
go ahead program. And talk about it right away.
Yeah, I got a plan. As of next year, based on the many former bosses, starting with Mr. Adrian Hall, Mr. Bobby Bryant, to the MD, who is the founder of it all, the kind of president, and that's why I commend her, is that by next year we must start doing what we call on-site quality control and quality assurance.
On-site?
On-site. What does that mean? And you see, many a times as a scientist, we follow some cultural event. We've got complaints from suppliers, customers, clients, who said the product carried to them wasn't good. On ground, okay, a particular truck in the LPRC loaded with a particular product carried to their client, and a client complained that the product is not good. When in fact, this very product was certified by the laboratory before even going to our tank. So what's causing the problem? So they called to do some investigation that would have put the company in the problem that we solved it. And the way we solve it, like you said, we follow train. The historicity of an event and cost must set the basis for a sanitary out there. So how we now show that, okay, you took it from our tank, but where did it go? Was your truck properly prepared to receive this product? Where did you carry? Who procured it? We found out at the end of the day, the client that received the product, storage facility was the one that contaminated the product. So, in our policy and proposal we're going to be making, we want to be following. So, quality control now will be a showing it this time. When we say it is true from LPRC, we want to follow it too on the guest to the consumer.
Okay.
So, we'll be doing on the fee or on-site quality assurance after control by visiting gas stations, storage area, and commercial area. And all we want to check on you periodically to make sure what you've taken from us is what you're giving to our people. So that it can be seen like you're taking this from us when in fact that is not the case. That's one thing. Another thing is we are preparing to start doing bitumen analysis. Bitumen is the one we call in a common English quota. Another name is called ASA, but it varies from region. The European sector and the American sector call it ASA and bitumen. You would not believe that most of the problem we have with roads is not because the engineer or those doing the road don't want to have the quota lane number. It's because of the quality of the asphalt. Because for us, our quality analysts and experts, there are certain components of the asphalt we look at and we tell you how long it stays. For instance, most asphalt or all asphalt in nature are thermoplastic.
In fact, for the layman down the asphalt means quota.
Quota.
Very good.
That's what many times I see, then I try to bring it the librarian with. So the asphalt or bitumen, which is interchangeably used based on the region from what is UN called quota.
Quota.
On a normal and best practice, when quota or asphalt is laid and properly done engineering from the quality advice, if you stay 10, 11 years before you see it first routing is the one we see the cracking, the fatigueness of the quota. But Mr. Kote, you believe me that you will agree with me that what the period and that is not what we see.
No.
When a particular road is paved with quota, we got 6 to 7 more in repair. It's abnormal.
Jalatan Road.
Very abnormal. And the reason for that is because the quality assurance part must be looked at. And I'm using this platform thank God the MD Matakuma has initiated through our bosses and working on this document to see that it be done. We hope that when the policies and advice through the scientists is sent to the national government, they should take our advice. Because I must tell you that sustainable development starts from the technicians. It must not start from the politicians. Areas our development that start from the politicians is superficial. Mm-hmm. Scientists is the one that bring the sustainable development. Sustainable development to me by it will serve present day generation and serve future generation. And there are components we look at in the alpha that determine the longevity of the alpha. For instance, we just told you that it's thermoplastic. So if it is thermoplastic, it means that the temperature have an impact on its temperature dependent. What kind of temperature? What's the climatic condition of your country? Another thing, if a certain temperature it becomes viscoelastic. And that viscoelasticity depends on the level of temperature. How high is the temperature within? Now with the issue of global warming coming, as policy advisor and environmental expert, we get the necessary advice and blend it with our quality and scientific sense. The component of asphalt is mineral, asphaltene, and resin. And the asphaltene, if you bring a quota here, I don't even have to go in the lab to determine the component in terms of quality to determine what will happen in the future. I can use a chemical called normal pentene. By the time I dissolve a particular asphalt into it and it refuses to dissolve, it may contain high level of asphaltene. And what asphaltene does is the more the asphaltene in the asphalt, it makes the quota harder. And when the quota is harder, that's when you suffer fatigue, it suffers routing. And there are tests, we got consistency tests, we got environmental tests, we got safety tests. Those tests are categorized on the basis of the sound's output. So yeah, those are their feature plan that the company is planning through the laboratory, through our recommendation and advice. And it's being honored by our bosses. That's a blessing we've had.
All right.
On sourcing and bitumen quality analysis.
That was going to be my next point. How much support? You have always praised all of your previous bosses, starting with COPI, PSN.
And those now are the ones that I've served.
Yeah, that's correct. Now you have a new boss, Madam Mary Colburn. Now, how much support are you getting from this new management?
I guess there's something here. And what was that? That LPRC have been blessed with his. Mm-hmm. So, by that and thereby context clue, you know what my answer will be? That she's good.
Good.
I'm going to tell you something on the radio that you will not believe. And go thank God you always visit the company going fine. Since that woman took over, we have not met. Since the MD took over the LPRC, we have not sat 101.
Okay.
But see the number of support going to the line. Hmm. In fact, the budget that was just passed for priority is laboratory revamping. In terms of structural analysis, in terms of structural something, in terms of personnel. In fact, she has said in one of her conversations from my bosses that I heard that she doesn't want to see a contractor in the laboratory, which is the best practice.
Okay.
A laboratory that is hazardous should not have somebody contracting. You must be insured, so therefore you must be employed. Because of that, you can't even be accredited and recognized by international body if a laboratory carrying a contractor. Mm-hmm. So therefore, from what my immediate boss has spoken about her in terms of her stance towards the laboratory personnel, if it is something to live by, which I know she will do, it's going to be one of the best things that the company will boast of.
Hmm.
Because currently I got two contractors and two volunteers in the laboratory. Now I can't blame her for if she came and saw them. Now if she take a stand and make sure the people are employed, it'll be one of the blessings the company will have, and she will have the normal approach she wanted the government will benefit from.
I see.
We're expecting what we're driving towards between quality analysis and also seeing that it'll have a quality follow-up, which is the best practice around the world, because we are the only regulatory body now. If we are regulated by every country, we must serve them. Mind you, we are not only serving locals. Foreign nationals are coming to the country using their missions. What are they going to say about the country? So people must look at these things holistically.
We'll soon be going to the break in a few minutes from now. Let me just ask you one more question that we can take a short break and open the lines for some participation from the public. And that's one thing you normally enjoy. You like to enjoy talking with the public.
Sure.
Answering their questions.
Sure.
Now, tell us about the different types of fuel or petroleum. We don't know these things. I know about the jet fuel. What is that? I know about the AGO. You need AGO. You got to tell us about that. The PMS, we want to know these different things. What can you tell us about them?
The best I can say for everyone, when I mean everyone, the expert, the scientists, and the common people, is
and
that
even the lay people like us.
The laymen, what I can say is that the one word is crude oil. Crude oil is a naturally grown substance beneath the earth. Now, crude oil is a conglomeration of decay waste from both living and non-living things. They accumulate into that thing we call crude. the crew ought to come out to what you're seeing now as gasoline, as diesel, as the factory, a scientific process called distillation. Now, in modern day world, there are different kind of distillation, hydrocracking, plastic cracking, all this kind of form. Those days were just one form of cracking. Now, what happens is if a barrel of crude goes into the distillation unit, that is an instrument where it is pulled and it is heated at very high temperature. A liquid come out at a particular kind of temperature. And that has an, so a single crude produces gasoline, diesel, gel fuel, petrochemical, and the one we call the alpha, which is the byproduct. And that's the reason why.
Oh, you mean, let me get this clear. One single crew can produce these different things.
These different things.
Based on what you do with it.
Based on the temperature being used at a particular distilling unit. And that's the reason why you see the temperature ranges are different. For instant gasoline, the minimum is 41 and the maximum is 200. So if you put a crew in a distilling unit and maybe you are using technology to apply heat, at 200, if at the minimum at 400 degrees Celsius, you should see a drop. But 200, whatever comes after 200 is no more gasoline. It goes in a different form. So at the temperature, so from minimum 40 to 200, you see gasoline drilling out. At that point, we do cut back, stop the machine, assume that there is no more gasoline in that crew.
In other words, for people like us, you can have a bag of flour that you will decide to make bread out of.
You can make bread. That cookies.
Cookies. That's so from the flour there, you can make rice bread, you can make corn bread, rice bread.
I like the analogy. You're supposed to be a scientist. I like the analogy. You found out that what happening? One thing is constant. What is that? The flour. The only thing that changes is the ingredient. For rice bread, you need a little bit of rice.
Yeah.
For the bread, you need a little bit of yeast, right?
Yes.
But flour goes. That's what happens. So with the distillation aspect, you only need temperature changes.
That's all.
Simple. And that's the reason why you see the color the way it is.
Yeah.
For the gasoline, the layman here see how the gasoline is red. It doesn't come red. It can't clear the water. We decided color, which is a quality kind of practice.
Like that. Okay, my guest is Mr. Sam P. Jala. He is the head of the laboratory department at LPRC. The department that is making LPRC, LPRC. Without that department, there will be no need for LPRC because LPRC has to do with petroleum, gasoline, fuel, and so on. So if they don't have a department that is qualified enough to make sure that we get something good on the market, there'll be no need. So it's very important to have this particular entity, and it's also important to have qualified people in that entity, like Mr. Jala. You will tell us a little bit about yourself just before we take the break.
I appreciate
it. I want you to tell the public who you really are. It's 11 o'clock. Let me inform the public, especially those of you who normally watch a repeat of this program in the evening on Saturday at 8 o'clock. This is a morning program. Most of the time in the evening, this is why this time when callers are calling in, I say good morning. I don't just say hello.
Yeah.
Because in the evening, I did not know that a lot of people watch the program in the evening. So my telephone sometimes doesn't rest. Like we use the numbers here, sometimes my phone too. So calls come in every evening, every Saturday.
While the repeat has been watched.
I say, Lord, it's a And normally I don't cut my phone off.
Yeah.
Because I don't want people to think we're fooling them.
You're right.
So when you call, I take my phone and say, I'm sorry, this is a repeat. It was done on Friday morning.
Great.
So, we'll say good morning here when you call because we're doing this on Friday morning. It's going to be repeated on Saturday evening. So before the lines open, I'd like to make it clear now. If you're watching TV tonight, don't call. It's a repeat. Tell me about a little bit about yourself. You know, sometimes I like my guests, my viewers and listeners to know who I'm dealing with. Tell me a little bit about yourself in this. I'm not talking about your marital status today.
Sure.
Just talk about the qualification a little bit in this area.
Mr. Cody, thank you. Again, I'm Sam P. Jala, full name.
Yes.
Middle name P stands for Patrick.
Yes.
Mr. Cody, I'm a scientist, pure scientist. I say this to me that all of my studies,
okay.
I've got 2 BSEs and masters. And I've got over 11 different certificates of training, both postgraduate and pregraduate.
And you don't look like it. I should be speaking that way because of the age now.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but you don't look like it.
Yeah, so when I say I'm a peer scientist, this is what I want to bring it down
and
to.
And you got confidence in yourself, that's all I like about you. You know, when people got confidence in themselves, I'm this, that's right, I'm a scientist.
Yeah, and when I say that, because I'm an environmentalist. I earned a degree as environmental science. Mm-hmm. I'm a mathematician. I earned a degree in mathematics. I'm a chemist. I got a degree in chemistry. And I'm a SOC 2, a physicist. Coming to my training and professional...
Your mother is listening to this program today.
She'd be too proud. Sorry that she's on letter, but the conversation will make good to her.
Yeah, so she can be proud of herself.
The good thing about it, that's my single parent currently. Yeah. My father is not alive. So
okay.
I'm proud of her, right? Because of her blessings.
And she's proud of you, too.
Sure. So, yeah, I'm a humanitarian also. I'm a young ambassador of peace certificated by United Nations in 2008. So which means, by virtue of that, it means I have the right to go in any war zone and nothing happens to me. I'm a young ambassador of peace. But then I was the national coordinator for the Youth Federation for World Peace, Liberia chapter, but it's an international-based organization. I commonly run a non-governmental organization that involves into environmental advocacy. You know, one of the things I've learned over the years is most of my academic pursuit that I've done and achieve my degree, I tried to practicalize it and not just waiting for people to employ me before I get a job. When I did my undergraduate chemistry at the University of Liberia, I did biodiesel as my research and converted red oil to diesel fuel. So it tells you how long life I have been in terms of pursuing this area and career. I love it to the extent that if I don't eat a day, I feel happy. I still feel going, just making research and making it so that. Because the thing about it, one of the things I've noticed is around the world, we make research development and the kind of infrastructure you're seeking as an advisor of the scientists, unlike in our country, your politics
if I don't hold you there, we're going to go for 24 hours. So, thank you very much. Let's stop there.
I appreciate it.
The program is Flashpoint, the voice of the coalition, and I'm David Coty. My special guest today is Mr. Sam Pijala, and he is the head of the laboratory department that is making sure that your cars are moving well. Your engines in the homes are moving well. He's a very important person at the LPRC. Now, when we take the break, we'll come back and open the lines so that you can be a part. The numbers you're going to be calling are 0776-089-713 or 0880-514-096. 514-096. I'm very good at numbers. He was boasting of being a scientist. I can boast of being a numberless.
Yeah, accu scientist.
So I said numberless. So I'm a scientist in numbers. I remember them very well.
Great.
There are 15 good friends of mine whose names I don't have in my phone. But I call them when I'm ready to call them, I talk to them. I got their numbers up here. It's just here. So 0776-089-713. That's the number you have to call, or 0880-514-096. Or you can try my personal number. Those of you who know me, you want to participate, is 0777-511-977. 0777-511-977. Thank you very much. Let's take a break and we'll be right back.
When the platform is set, we talk tough. Discussing issues of national concern. One full hour of patriotic discussion with difficulty. This and every Friday, exclusively on Aaron TV. Flashpoint. Liberia is getting better.
Well, thank you very much. We are back. That's the sound of Selus Keita, He's a Guinean, and that's the best hymn song right now in the country. It's called Chikele. Very beautiful song. When people hear this thing, they think I'm a Madingo man. No, I'm not. I'm a Buzo man, but I just love that music a whole lot. All right, we're back, and the program is Flashpoint. Originally, Liberia is getting better, but now, the voice of the coalition. Our special guest today, Mr. Sampi Jala. He's the head of the laboratory department at LPRC. Well, you are free not to call and ask your questions while we are talking one or two other issues. If you have a question or accommodation, you are free to call and make a comment or tell us what you have in mind. Maybe you have some questions about a different type of fuel. Do we have a caller? All right. If you have noticed anything you want to ask Mr. Jala about, you can go ahead. Feel free to do so. He's prepared to answer any question. All right. Now. Okay. All right.
Hello?
Yeah. Hello?
Yeah, this is connected one from the Bar of New
Bhutan. Okay, go right ahead, sir.
I want to say thank you for the super guest.
Yes?
But you said something quickly that I want to ask him a question.
Yes.
You said that the laboratory is fighting for accreditation. And I also understand from you that you have volunteers and a contractor within the laboratory. Can this help him to have that accreditation?
You say you heard him say?
I got a question.
Okay, you got a question. Okay.
So you want me to respond right later or now? I can do that.
Okay. All right. That's a very fine point. Thank you very much. Please cut your phone off. He's going to answer you. Just cut the phone off. Okay. Now, let's see whether we can attempt to answer that while we're waiting for another call.
The call in sequence?
Yeah. Maybe before a call can come in. All right. Let's take this caller. All right. We just lost the caller. You can please attempt to answer that.
Yeah. My brother, your point is right. Scientifically and in terms of the procedure that is laid down for accreditation, you don't have contractor and volunteer being part of the process. The reason is simple. In accreditation process, they got something called personal profile. And in that personal profile, they want to know your qualification, your competence. The next thing that follows is a remuneration. What are you taking home? Because the thing about it, in quality control, they assume that you attempted with bribery to circumvent the policy of quality and come to something unscrupulous. So what happens is, those things at play. But you get hold from me, I told you that we are very happy for the kind of MD we have. In her plan, those things are going to be solved in the shortest possible time before accreditation is achieved. Thank you.
All right. Let's take this caller. Good morning.
Hello?
Hello?
This is Mr. Georgie Gifty from District of Bong County, but personally in EWA Market.
Okay, go right ahead, sir.
Yeah, what I want to get clear from the studio guest is, you know, tomorrow we have been on the traffic for a little while. The gas that we use those days, as compared to today's gas, there is big differences. Even the thickness of the gas having the filter go on your lip, it has too much and it's part of a stain and it's colorless. What is the real cause of the gas being stained too much? And it has different colors like this. What a vehicle is this, the formulation of it or the manufacturing of it? Really, I really want you to throw light on that.
All right. Thank you very much. Let's see whether we can touch our quicker before a call comes in.
All right, Mr. Gibson, I want to say thank you for the point. But let me say something. Like you said, I like the way your statement ends.
Please call up your phone. We're getting the feedback here. All right. Go ahead.
Yeah, Mr. Gibson, I want to say thank you for the question. And let me say that I like the way you ended it. Most of these things sometimes are not really derived from the process of being not good or in the simple term or the quality is low. Let's look at color. If you speak of gasoline comes colorless. If I show you gasoline, it's the same as kerosene when it comes from the refinery. All the coloring you see is being made by the regulatory body. Like for us in Liberia, we choose red. You go right to South Africa, every state got their own color. You see blue. You remember when Omi was in this country, we had blue gasoline. Because Omi had decided that they wanted that gasoline to be blue so that it can be mixed with other gasoline. In terms of the odor. Now, that's the reason why we are embarking on this and having a policy to have an on-site quality control and assurance. Because the hydrocarbon that we qualify from the laboratory at LPRC goes into our tank. They all meet specification. But then, you know, the human nature now. When people take these things from the terminal and go out there, they do something we refer to in our terminology called attenuation. Attenuation is a process where you try to add things to make the volume increase and thereby lowering the quality. So sometimes you will get, that could be some of the reason of that kind of sting that you're talking about. In terms of hurt, yeah. I was just talking something with the host here, that crew comes and when it is distilled, distilled into different facets, the one you call it gathering, the diesel and the jet fuel. If a particular country that needs, that is a demand for PMS, which is a gasoline, and they think they want more, we do something called additive. They add more additive to increase the production level. And that too can be the reason for quality, depending on your country specification. So yeah, that's all I can tell you so far.
And he also talk about it being tin. Do you have a color? All right. He says it's always tin.
Tin, what do you mean tin? Light?
Light, yeah.
Oh yeah, there are something in quality control referred to as the ROVV, that is the rear valve pressure. That speaks about the volatility of the product. So the more volatile the product is going to be, thin or lead, the way you call it. So yeah, it depends. But mind you now, all the quality of product we talk about, they comes into different grade. For instance, you're like, bro, we don't know diesel to be diesel, but you wouldn't believe that they are selling diesel in their country when I show you, you think that they are kerosene. So we got light diesel, heavy and extremely heavy. The same thing go with gasoline. Mm-hmm. But it depends on what you're using it for.
Yeah. All right. 0777-511-977 is the number to call. Or 0776-089-713. Or 0880-514-096. Any of those three numbers you can call and ask your question or make your comment. Most people are concerned about the colors, especially me. Does that give any... Okay, let's see if we can take this call. Good morning.
Yeah, good morning.
Good morning.
All right, I'm Gitao Ikoi from Granville County, District Number 2.
Oh, good.
I was attending to your studio guest.
Thank you.
You know, for me, I don't have comment, I don't have question. I want to appreciate you this morning.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you very much, and thank you.
But let me ask you a
thank
question.
You,
hello?
For being a nationalist.
Are you gone? Oh, okay. I wanted to ask him, where is District Number 2? Is Zulu Whiskey? That's the name I love to hear. When I used to hear Zulu Whiskey, I thought it was a different place, but they said that's the name of the capital city, Zulu Whiskey. Yeah, so Granville, that's a good place to be. All right, he wants to just say thank you. You see, some people admire you.
Yeah, I appreciate that because, like you said, right, as the country progress, they must take under the international standard. And what is that? Station at EIBG, which is the state-run radio station, must have a segment for what we call scientific contribution to the country, and not just politics. That's one. Two, those things that has the impact on the welfare of the people, those professionals must kind of say something about it.
Yeah.
And by that, you inform them and make them to understand. And you, like you just, like we just said, by next year, when we hit the year and start to implement some of those things, we say, outside the company, we're going to come to the radio and tell people so they can benefit themselves. Mm-hmm. In other countries, you go to the gas station, you will know the kind of gasoline you're pumping into your car because every vehicle is calibrated to the quality standard of that hydrocarbon.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Let's try this caller.
Good morning.
Good morning to you.
My name is Lawrence E. Wah.
Okay.
And I have a question for the guest there.
Go ahead, sir.
Yeah, I want to know whether LPRNC only sold you for this edition to zero customers or they carry on fractional distillation to produce fuel before this edition.
Oh, well, I don't know whether he is here to answer that.
Yeah, I can do that. At the moment, we are only importing, storing, and regulating. So it should not there be like only storing. We are storing, importing, and regulating. So importers bring their product and they're supposed to import. We follow that process of importation, come to our country because we're concerned about the product. Now, but mind you now, the issue of refining petroleum product, LPRC was into it. That's why it's called LPRC, Liberian Petroleum Refinery. At the moment, LPRC is not refining but preparing for refinery.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, sorry, I have a breakthrough. Same question I just was already
one. Okay. Yeah, you want to ask another question?
Yeah,
but he
did you get the answer?
You got an answer?
Maybe you're listening to it off.
Yeah, okay.
So yeah, Mr. Watt, that's it. LPRC is storing, is regulating, and it's also following on the importation of petroleum products. They are not refining at the moment, but I can tell you, just in the shorter distant future, you're going to hear refining going on at LPRC.
Okay. I think Mr. Bobby Brown answered that one time when he came here.
Perfect.
So it's called a Liberia Petroleum and Refining Company.
Correct.
Right now, the refining is not going on, but it's going to happen in the future.
Because refining project, refining or petroleum products take process.
Yeah.
The environmental impact assessment must be looked at. The control and consumption rate must be looked at. What is the market for refining must also be looked at.
Okay. Now, when you do these different colors, don't you have any negative impact? Does it not reduce the quality? I mean, I don't know. What do you put in there to change the color? For example, oil mill use blue. That's the color they wanted.
Perfect.
To distinguish a fuel from the other fuel.
Thank
now,
you
in Liberia, or we here, choose to have red. Don't you have a problem with the quality when you put the coloring in there? But before you answer that, 0777-511-977, 0776-089-713. All right, let's take this caller. Good morning.
Yeah, good morning.
Good morning to you.
I'm M.D. Harris.
Yes.
On Rawa C Highway.
Okay.
Thanks for the show.
Thank you.
Yeah, I just want to ask them a question.
Okay.
With all his scientific knowledge, does he do anything outside the petroleum industry? For example, we have gold, we have silver, you know, what have you. And these things are exported in the raw state here. Is there any way that they can be pre-refined or, you know, added value to them instead of just going out in the raw state, bauxite and other things? Is that anything in his area?
Okay. He's talking mainly now about your qualification.
Go ahead. All right, Mr. Harris, I want to say thank you. I almost think the way you enter your question, I almost asked whether you are diving into my personal life or the work at LPR. LPR is their hydrocarbon. Also, that I can tell you yes. I just said to you here that my previous work I've had went into quality. For instance, my last job before taking on LPR was SGS. I did quality analysis on iron ore. So that I could have done quality analysis on iron ore, I've got some training on mineral quality analysis. And like you said, my friend, the quality output of your product when it is exported, it yield more money than when it go raw. So yeah, I'm involved. I can do a quality analysis on diamond, quality analysis on iron ore. I can do quality analysis on gold.
Maybe you gotta be careful. Maybe that man has an employment waiting for you.
No, but anybody wanting me out of LPRC now to be stronger than LPRC, which is part of the professional.
In other words, they must pay you not double, not triple.
Besides giving the PET, sometimes as a professional, you come to the job with passion.
Mm-hmm.
What's your passion? You think that from the time I got a job, I've not been given offer? In fact, in a very quality assurance of hydrocarbon, I've gotten offers.
Mm-hmm.
But is it passion and.
Yeah, but you just matters. Said he has to be strong. Mr. Harris, is it Mr. Harris?
Yeah.
He has a job for you. You got to be careful now. So in other words, he must come not double, not triple, but quadruple. You better put the money four times. All right. Hello, good morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
Yeah, good morning to you.
Yeah, my name is Kwame. I'm calling for Zulu Whiskey.
Oh, Zulu Whiskey. Go ahead, my brother. No, let me get that question.
Yeah, I don't know if it's possible for LPR.
Yeah, to supply a good to a vendor on LPRC that is not useful to the market.
Okay.
Automatically, B answer no. The reason we are regulated, one of the advantages LPRC has is we are not a contractual laboratory. What we get paid on the basis of the normal tests we do. We are paid, even tests is not done. That's why we are autonomous. And besides that, we are regulating for the entire country. There is no way we should do that. Because when it happens, it's for the country need.
All right. Okay, we got only 5 minutes to go. Maybe we can take one more lucky caller. That would be good. But we got 5 minutes to go. Let's announce the numbers once again. Maybe somebody will come in. 0777-511-977. 0776-089-713 or 0880-51409. We got that lucky caller. Good morning.
Hello?
Hello?
Yeah, this is Andrew Lawrence.
Okay, Mr. Lawrence, go ahead.
I just like to congratulate my former sponsor. I have an education for his program.
Okay. Well, thank you. Now, let's take it from this way.
So you got out on
the... Yeah, from the orange right here. Let's take it from this orange line. Good morning. Yes. You're too low. Okay, I'll go ahead.
All right, I want to ask a question.
Yes. All right. That's the last caller. The type of gasoline we use in Liberia.
The short answer is PMS, Premium Motor Spirit. And the reason why it's called Premium is because the quality stands as the octane number of minimum 91. Simple. They got all the PMS, all the gasoline that are not called PMS. The fact that your gasoline is called PMA means the octane rating is minimum at 91. The octane rating of the gasoline tells the quality at which it burns. So it's going to depend on your vehicle emission strategy. For Liberia, that's what we have. You go to America, they got gasoline that is 86, 76. So they are not called PMS. But for here, we call it PMS. So in terms of type, it's PMS, Premium Motor Spirit. In terms of coding, it's because the octane rating is minimum 91. And okay, that is a test that we do in the laboratory.
Thank you. Let's just try this last caller from this end. Good morning to you.
And good morning, sir. Thank you very much. My name is Sheikha Chibomune.
Okay.
And I'm calling for Jacob's Village.
All right.
Let me say bravo and the stewardess.
Okay.
I like the way you put it. Those are contacted are in the lab. It is harmful. My question is that do other workers that are in a terminal that are not in draw, because I believe that chemical have a bad product. That is why most of them begin to drink. So those contacted are in a terminal, is there harmful for them? Because most of them are not in draw. So what happened to them? That's my question.
Okay. Thank you. You got a question.
All I can say in terms of employment is administrative. I got no real to say on that. In terms of the sanitary output, it's not good. Like you just said, that's how we got PPE. That is PPE, the personal protective equipment. Those things are being worn by people.
Yeah.
Now, many a time, let's get this straight. This is not only unique to Liberia. Every multinational company around the world normally have short-time employees, short-time people to work. So they are referred to as contractor. Many a time, some volunteers are referred to as interns in other environments. But yeah, we just call them volunteers. It's because those are people who got a passion for the job. But mind you now, company will hire you on the basis of their wage bill.
Thank you.
And you can't keep increasing the money now.
No. Well, thank you very much. We can't take any more calls. I'd like to say many, many thanks to all of the callers, those who commended my guest because of his qualification and competence. Thank you. Those who asked some very sound questions, thank you very much also. I think the public learned from all of us. Now, we just got roughly 3 minutes in the studio. What are your final comments?
All I can say is first thank you to ERBC and by extension, Mr. Kuti.
Yeah.
I think you're doing a wonderful job. I just hope that this nation will remember you for that and you get the fruit of your labor.
Yeah.
The next thing I want to say is, Manakumo, we've not met in person, but I'm too proud of you. You've demonstrated professionalism since you took over. The fact that you've come to the company and try to look at, I refer to the lab as the entry point of LPRC in terms of revenue generation and in terms of the stability of the company. That you are seeing us, we want to say thank you for that, and we hope that God will guide you as you go through your processes. The laboratory is there for you. Count on us for quality control, and we're going to do that. Look at our staff in terms of remuneration, in terms of professionalism, in terms of training, which you're doing, in terms of equipment and structure. Mr. Bobby Brown, I want to say thank you for being a wonderful boy. Thank you for being knowledgeable. Mr. Adrian Hoff, I want to say thank you for coming to LPR. You're one of the newest on the block, but you've demonstrated how do. You've been there even before more than 10-5 years. To my staff in the lab, I want to say thank you for the cooperation. Sometimes we have the fight professionally, but we sometimes resolve our thing and see that the country is served. The last but not the least, which is my heartbeat, I want to say Musso Anthony, my mother, thank you for making me a son who I am today. Thank you for your prayer and continue that for us. Wow. I want to say thank to this country for the opportunity giving us and to God who is for us. Thank you very much.
Well, let me say many thanks to you for coming and thanks to this and the administration of ELBC also for allowing us to be here to invite guests to be on this show. Let me just give you a health tip quickly before I close. You know, I've invited roughly 11 medical doctors here, and I'm going to continue to do so. Let me give you a health tip today. Do not use your teeth as an opener. There are some of you who take the soft drink bottle, the beer bottle, and just open it, blow up with your teeth. It's not good. It will break the white part of the teeth called the enamel. And when that happens, you have a hole in the teeth or in your tooth, if it is one. And when that happens, rice cream will drop in our hole, meat will drop in our hole, when you eat, fish will drop there, and when it gets rotten, it will make your mouth to smell. And try to see if you can check the hospital once every 6 months to clean your teeth, to check your teeth. So that if there's any hole in the teeth, it can be closed. We call it cavity. When that hole is closed, when the doctor closes the hole, the dentist closes the hole, you have no problem. But if you don't do so, when that hole is there, because you're not checking your teeth, 6 months, 7 months, one whole year, you just eat in the morning, in the evening, you drink your cane juice, everything, you don't check. When the hole gets there, rice cream will get inside it, and when it gets rotten, then you have what we call bad breath. Do not use your teeth as an opener to open soft drink. And number two, check the hospital at JFK to clean your teeth once every 6 months or once a year. It's very good to check it. Thank you very much. The show has been Flashpoint, the voice of the coalition. And I'm David Cote. Bye-bye.
When the platform is set, we talk tough. Discussing issues of national concern. One full hour of patriotic discussion with difficulty. This and every Friday, exclusively on Aaron TV. Flashpoint. Liberia is getting better.
Take it off on me, take it off on you, muscle.